Good morning. Indeed, good morning and welcome to the vineyard of St. Barnabas. Jesus Christ, through the parable, said, "Ye also go." And you did. You came to the vineyard of St. Barnabas to reap the fruits of the gospel and to sing praises to the Lord. We indeed are privileged that we can come in peace to gather around the Lord's table today. And of course, there are many things that happen during the week and during the months, and these are all written on the back of your bulletin. And I encourage you to read the back of your bulletin to find out about midweek services at Chapel Jardins, ordination to the diaconate of Dave, well, he'll be there soon, Bible studies to come, parish council meetings, where you can find out more about your parish and how you can get involved in your parish. And of course, the choir. If you haven't heard them, wait till you hear the choir. And yes, you can be part of that choir. And after service fellowship with refreshments begins next week. So you won't want to miss it, will you? Because the coffee hour at St. Barnabas, oh, it's like the best vineyard you could find, right, Barbara? But in the meantime, let us stand together and sing our opening hymn, Glorious Things of Thee Are Spoken.
Thank you. Seigneur, l'amour de Dieu le Père et la communion de l'Esprit Saint soient toujours avec vous.
Et avec ton esprit.
Almighty God,
to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest,
and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High. Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And now as we prepare our hearts to hear God's word, let us continue in prayer. Almighty God, you have created the heavens and the earth and ourselves in your image. Teach us to discern your hand in all your works, to serve you with reverence and thanksgiving. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
The reading is taken from the book of Exodus. The whole congregation of the Israelites complained against Moses and Aaron in the wilderness. The Israelites said to them, "If only we had died by the hand of the Lord in the land of Egypt, when we sat by the flesh pots and ate our fill of bread. For you have brought us out into this wilderness to kill this whole assembly with hunger." Then the Lord said to Moses, "I am going to rain bread from heaven for you, and each day the people shall go out and gather enough for that day. In that way I will test them, whether they will follow my instruction or not. On the sixth day, when they prepare what they bring in, it will be twice as much as they gather on other days." So Moses and Aaron said to all the Israelites, "In the evening you shall know that it was the Lord who brought you out of the land of Egypt. And in the morning you shall see the glory of the Lord, because he has heard your complaining against the Lord. For what are we that you complain against us?" And Moses said, "When the Lord gives you meat to eat in the evening and your fill of bread in the morning, because the Lord has heard the complaining that you utter against him, what are we? Your complaining is not against us, but against the Lord." Then Moses said to Aaron, "Say to the whole congregation of the Israelites, draw near to the Lord, for he has heard your complaining." And as Aaron spoke to the whole congregation of the Israelites, they looked towards the wilderness, and the glory of the Lord appeared in the cloud. The Lord spoke to Moses and said, "I have heard the complaining of the Israelites. Say to them, at twilight you shall eat meat, and in the morning you shall have your fill of bread. Then you shall know that I am the Lord your God." In the evening, quails came up and covered the camp. And in the morning, there was a layer of dew around the camp. When the layer of dew lifted, there, on the surface of the wilderness, was a fine, flaky substance, as fine as frost on the ground. When the Israelites saw it, they said to one another, "What is it?" For they did not know what it was. Moses said to them, "It is the bread that the Lord has given you to eat." Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church.
Our psalm this morning is taken from Psalm 105. Give thanks to the Lord and call upon his name. Sing to him, sing praises to him. Glory in his holy name. Search for the Lord and his strength. Remember the marvels he has done. O offspring of Abraham, his servant, he led out his people with silver and gold. Egypt was glad of their going. He spread out a cloud for a covering. They asked, and quails appeared. He opened the rock, and water flowed. For God remembered his holy word. So he led forth his people with gladness. He gave his people the lands of the nations, that they might keep his statutes. Hallelujah. God of our salvation, through the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ, you have fulfilled your promise to our ancestors in the faith to redeem the world from slavery and to lead us into the promised land. Grant us living water from the rock and bread from heaven, that we may survive our desert pilgrimage and praise you forever through Jesus Christ, our Redeemer.
A reading to the Philippians. For to me, living is Christ, and dying is gain. If I am to live in the flesh, that means fruitful labor for me, and I do not know which I prefer. I am hard-pressed between the two. My desire is to depart and be with Christ, for that is far better. But to remain in the flesh is more necessary for you. Since I am convinced of this, I know that I will remain and continue with all of you for your progress and joy in faith, so that I may share abundantly in your boasting in Christ Jesus when I come to you again. Only live your life in a manner worthy of the gospel of Christ, so that whether I come and see you or am absent and hear about you, I will know that you are standing firm in one spirit, striving side by side with one mind for the faith of the gospel, and are no way intimidated by your opponents. For them, this is evidence of their destruction, but of your salvation. And this is God's doing. For he has graciously granted you the privilege not only of believing in Christ, but of suffering for him as well, since you are having the same struggle that you saw I had, and now hear that I still have. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church.
Thank you. Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out early in the morning to hire laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with the laborers for the usual daily wage, he sent them into his vineyard. When he went out at about 9 o'clock, he saw others standing idle in the marketplace. And he said to them, "You also go into the vineyard, and I will pay you whatever is right." So they went. When he went out again about noon and about 3 o'clock, he did the same. And about 5 o'clock, he went out and found others standing around. And he said to them, "Why are you standing here idle all day?" They said to him, "Because no one has hired us." He said to them, "You also go into the vineyard." When evening came, the owner of the vineyard said to his manager, "Call the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and then going to the first." When those hired about 5 o'clock came, each of them received the usual daily wage. Now when the first came, they thought they would receive more, but each of them also received the usual daily wage. And when they received it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "These last worked only 1 hour, and you have made them equal to us, who have borne the burden of the day and the scorching heat." But he replied to them, "Friend, I am doing you no wrong. And did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what belongs to you and go. I choose to give to the last the same as I give to you. Am I not allowed to do what I choose with that what belongs to me? Or are you envious because I am generous?" So the last will be first, and the first will be last. The Gospel of Christ.
Singing when you provide so much for us. We give thanks for the people who have come here today and for those who are listening in, that they have come indeed to be in your vineyard to reap the fruits for the Holy Kingdom. Bless the words of my mouth, that they indeed be your words and your words alone. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior, we pray. Amen. Please be seated.
Eh bien, vous aussi, allez travailler dans ma vigne. C'est ça que Jésus a dit à tout le monde avec cette parabole. Go and work in my vineyard. Have any of you ever been to a vineyard? So, you're all going to go to a vineyard. You're going to get on a bus, you're going to get in some cars, you're going to arrange a trip. And you're going to go to a vineyard. And you're saying, "Well, we have to go to Ontario." No. We have vineyards that win international awards here in Quebec, just down the road. just down the road and around the corner from where Joan lives. We have phenomenal vineyards in Quebec where you can make an appointment, you can show up and ask for the owner and say, could you show me your vineyard? Can you show me what is necessary to produce these award-winning vines and wines? And they will be more than pleased. Just as pleased as those of you who invite people to your church on a Sunday morning and show them around and show them the work that's been happening in the vine. Because we can go into the SAQ, we can go into the Metro store, we can pull one off the rack, but what goes into making a bottle of wine is a lot of work and a lot of energy. Just trimming the branches and making sure the weeds aren't growing to suck the nutrients away from the vine. When we were on vacation in Gaspé, we met a young man working the tables in a fine restaurant. And he said to us, you need to go to this vineyard that's run by Tony. So we went to Tony's vineyard. But this young man said that his job was to prune the bushes, to trim away the extra foliage, to allow the air to go underneath it, to get rid of the weeds and to make sure that there was proper irrigation. And he said, I did that for a few years. And I said, do you realize how important that was? That if it wasn't for you, Tony would not have been making all the money that he did, because he wouldn't have reaped the fruit that was intended from that vine. It takes time, it takes energy, it takes knowledge, it takes experience, it takes dedication to build a vine, to bring fruit from that vine. Whether it's one of our vineyards down in Dunham, or this vineyard, St. Barnabas Church here in St. Lambert. To clean it, to trim it, and to fill it with all of the nutrients to truly bring the word of God to the people. And there's this beautiful story of the laborers in the vineyard. And Jesus explains it as the kingdom of heaven, of a landowner who goes out early in the morning. And although they can work all summer long and even in the winter to watch their crops to make sure that their vines do not freeze and wither. This was probably at harvest time. The oh so critical harvest time. You can't do it too early and you sure can't do it too late. And so early in the morning, probably 5 o'clock in the morning, he goes down to the marketplace with his wagon and he picks up people. Picks up probably migrant workers. If it wasn't for the migrant workers, you wouldn't eat today. Again, I encourage you to see our vineyards here in Quebec and see who's working the fields, who's working our fields. And so he puts them to work, he agrees to a wage, and then he goes back again at 9 o'clock, and he hires some more, and he goes back again at noon, and he hires some more, and he goes back again at 3 o'clock, and he hires some more. And then he goes back at 5 o'clock. This is the fall. It's going to be dark soon. And he hires some more, and he puts them to work. When I was in the typesetting business, we would prepare annual reports and documentation, and everything was on a deadline. If we didn't deliver the proofs for the next morning at 8 o'clock a.m., the president and chairman of the board didn't have his proofs or her proofs. They couldn't go to their board meetings where people have flown in from all over the country to manage these major corporations. If we didn't deliver the proofs on time, we didn't get paid. Trust me, I always got paid. Because sometimes we'd call people up at 4 o'clock in the morning and say, could you come in? We need some help to get this work done by 8 o'clock in the morning. And so they'd come in and they'd spend an hour and a half, and they'd get 3 hours minimum pay, and we'd pay their taxes. Because of the importance of finishing that job, getting it ready, getting it delivered, getting all the fruit off the vine so that nothing is wasted. And that last fruit in that last hour is pure profit. The overhead's been paid by all the other people. That last hour of 5 or 6 people could be thousands of dollars of pure profit. and no waste. But what happens when it comes time to pay, where the owner decides to pay what he wishes? There's grumbling. We don't grumble. Ask Joyce if Brian ever grumbles. I grumble too much, and I shouldn't. I had a good experience on Friday. I wasn't getting the information I needed. It was simple information. And so I grumble all day long, worried about this information that was so simple. An email, a phone, a text could have just said, here you go. But it wasn't until the final hour at 5 o'clock, not only did I get the information, I had a long chat with the person. And oh, the fruit vine was abundant, because I got all kinds of other questions answered. And I came in and I said to Joyce, why do I grumble? Perhaps all of that happened so that I could have that conversation. She said, well, I know that, but I guess you had to figure it out, didn't you? What do we have to figure out in our lives, and why do we grumble when everything is there for the taking, everything is there for the picking, the vine is ready to be beholden? But people grumble. They grumbled against the landowner. And he even lines them up that the last ones in are the first to get paid, to set an example. And the first ones in are the last to get paid. Perhaps it was 20 minutes of them giving out their day's wages, a denarii. This text, it talks about also, for as many as are called, few are chosen. The Lord can be generous as he wishes to whom he wishes, because the Lord realizes the plan that God has for his vineyard, for this church. But so often we complain because it's not going the way we had intended it to. We hear of grumbling, I still hear of grumbling. Well, what happens when you grumble? You lose out on the opportunity. I lost out on the opportunity of truly enjoying my Friday because I grumbled about information I didn't have that, of course, it would come. There are people who are grumbling about the affairs of this church, and they're missing out on what you're experiencing today. And what you're experiencing today, those in camera land, because of grumbling. And yet, if we were all to show up on the same day, we'd really run out of bulletins, not just like today. We apologize for those of you who have to share a bulletin, but get to know your neighbor. It's a good thing. The Israelites grumbled. They grumbled against the Lord. They weren't grumbling against Moses. The people aren't grumbling against me. They're grumbling against the Lord. But the Lord says, draw near, I hear your complaining. The Lord heard my complaining on Friday, and he delivered me. And he delivered Joyce from my complaining as well. And he gave them the bread to eat. He gave them the sustenance to sustain them. And they looked at it and they said, what is this? And he said, it is the bread that the Lord has given you to eat. Do you realize that you've come here today to hear the word of God, to sing praises to God, to receive the bread, to receive the wine, to receive the manna, to receive the bread of heaven, sacrificed and given for you, and that is your promise of eternal life? Will you come up and say, well, can I have a bigger piece? Or will you grumble? No, you won't, because you'll come up with a good, sincere heart. And perhaps you might even ask for one to take to a friend who is not here today. And I'll pray over that, that all who looks upon this bread sees the face of God and receives the face of God in their heart, which is their salvation. That is the work we have of working the vine, despite the struggle. Paul was speaking to the Philippians, for to me living is Christ. And he wants to live in a manner that is worthy of the gospel of Christ. Do we live in a manner that is worthy of the gospel of Christ? My Friday was not in the manner of the gospel of Christ. It was grumbling. But once I had the phone call, I had a good Friday evening. It was in the manner of the gospel. Yes, there was a little bit of wine. There was a little bit of cheer. But we were at peace. Can we not be at peace when we hear this? But we will have struggles. There will always be struggles. That's what Paul says. And having the same struggle that you saw I had and now hear that I still have. I still have struggles. There's still stuff out there. But it too will go away and be made public. But what does this word struggle mean? The Greek word is agon. I think it's short for agony. Isn't our struggle sometimes an agony, but somehow it goes away? Agon, that is to say, amid all hindrances, let us exert ourselves to the utmost to attain the goal of perfection set before the followers of Jesus Christ, that any struggle with dangers, annoyances, obstacles, standing in the way of faith, our holiness, and our desire to spread the gospel. What are the annoyances and the struggles that are standing in the way of you spreading the gospel, taking the bread of heaven to somebody who's in need, or taking it in yourself today, realizing that simply by saying, Lord Jesus Christ, forgive me, you have a clean heart ready to accept the bread of heaven in your heart today. So don't grumble, be happy. Ne râlez pas d'être heureux. Our psalm is so beautiful. The people were grumbling and they asked and quails appeared and he satisfied them with bread from heaven. And next week we'll see where he opened the rock and the water flowed so the river ran in dry places. He gave his people the land of the nations. God has given this church the land of the nations. Five congregations worship here in different languages. Yesterday there was a funeral, there was a wedding. Sorry, I get those mixed up sometimes. I should. There was a beautiful wedding here yesterday. The Chinese congregations have come to realize that if you're going to get married, you get married at St. Barnabas. It's the place to be. The nations are coming to worship and be celebrated in the sacraments. He opened the rock and the water flowed, and so the river ran in dry places. He gave his people the land of the nations, and they took of the fruit the others' toil. People have worked hard over the centuries. Barbara can tell you, Paul can tell you. Others can tell you of the work that's been put into this church over the years to bring it to the situation and place that it is. But we are in the final hour. And the new people coming in, it is your job also to rally around to bring the gospel to your friends and to your families and to our neighbors. Oh, Heavenly Father, grant us living water from the rock and bread from heaven, that we may survive our desert pilgrimage and praise you forever. Through Jesus Christ, our Redeemer. Amen.
Stand together and say the Apostles' Creed and confess our faith as we say, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit
and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Dear friends in Christ, God is steadfast in love and infinite in mercy. He welcomes all the faithful who return and invites them to his table. Let us confess our debts, confident in God's forgiveness. Most merciful God, we confess our shortcomings against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our prayers to the people begin this morning with these words. We wonder and we question how we are to follow the Lord. In our lives, all of us need to hear the words given from God, understand the guiding of each of us to go out in his name. Taking this guidance, we are to move out without fear, taking in these words from God, you also go. We pray for the church, that we may humbly accept God's gift of salvation and recognize that every day is God's gift to us. Praying to God, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for an end to ungrateful words and actions, that we can become more aware of grumbling that happens in our lives. To continue in this way allows God to fully see and hear our reactions to those things given to us and not appreciated. Help us to change our ways. Praying to God, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for all who are seeking God, that the Spirit of God will lead them into an encounter with God and open them to God's presence and actions in their lives. Praying to God, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for freedom from envy, that we may appreciate the gifts and blessings that others receive and rejoice in their success. Praying to God, Lord, hear our prayer. Nous prions pour tous ceux qui ont perdu espoir ou qui sont isolés de leur famille et de leurs amis, afin qu'ils puissent expérimenter aujourd'hui la présence de Dieu avec eux et reconnaître l'amour de quelqu'un pour eux. Prions le Seigneur. Seigneur, écoute nos prières. We pray for learning to live as Paul the Apostle did. We are not meant to continue to live in the ways of many in this world. Paul was fully aware of the actions of his world and decided that he will stay in Philippi to allow faith to continue progressing and for joy to be set in place. Praying to God, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for ways to be able to be aware of our equality amongst ourselves, that you may show us that we cannot present ourselves in any ways of a higher level of importance than anyone else. That in Jesus' time, he went out and chose 12 everyday men as apostles, and we, in our time, cannot seek out people who are any better than any of us as we work to be just like Christ. Praying to God, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for the great stewardship of creation, that God will help our hearts to oppose the misuse of Earth's resources and empower us to work tirelessly to protect the magnificence of nature for future generations. Praying to God, Lord, hear our prayer. And we pray for all who are suffering, that God will heal the sick and those living with various medical conditions, that he will bring comfort to those who are isolated, those fleeing violence, those seeking employment, and those handling the responsibilities of caregiver. We also remember those who have died and lift up their names, Wanda Rainsford. And we also remember those whose names have been supplied as ones in need of prayer for their caring. Either aloud or in silence, Donald Jones, Peter Johnson, Steve Wilson, Ros McGregor. Praying to God, Lord, hear our prayer. Amen. Que la paix du Seigneur soit toujours avec vous et avec ton esprit.
God of power, the glory of your work fills us with wonder and awe. Accept our offering this day and help us to live in peace and harmony with all your creation. For the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and your praise.
Blessed are you, gracious God, creator of heaven and earth. We give you thanks and praise through Jesus Christ our Lord, who after his resurrection sent forth apostles to preach the gospel and to teach all nations, and promised to be with them always, even to the end of the ages. Therefore, with angels and archangels and all your holy people, we raise our voices to proclaim the glory of your name. Thanks to you, Lord our God, for the goodness and love you have made known to us in creation, in calling Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all, in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days, you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him, you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him, you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, and out of death into life. On the night that Jesus was handed over to suffering and death, a death he freely accepted, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, Jesus took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, Father, according to his command, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory. Et nous t'offrons ce sacrifice de louange et d'action de grâce. Seigneur de l'univers, te présentant ce pain et ce vin, fruit de ta création, nous te supplions, Dieu éternel, charité, d'envoyer ton Esprit Saint sur ses enfants, afin qu'elle devienne le sacrement du corps de Christ et du sang de la nouvelle alliance. Unis tes fidèles au sacrifice de ton Fils, afin que rendu digne de toi par le Christ, il soit sanctifié par l'Esprit Saint. And in the fullness of time, reconcile all things in Christ and make them new. And bring us to that city of light where you dwell with all your sons and daughters through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church and the author of our salvation, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Et maintenant, comme nous l'avons appris de sauveur, nous osons dire dans la langue de votre choix. Notre Père, qui est aux cieux, que ton nom soit sanctifié, que ton règne vienne, que ta volonté soit faite sur la terre comme au ciel. Donne-nous aujourd'hui notre pain de ce jour. Pardonne-nous nos offenses, comme nous pardonnons aussi à ceux qui nous ont offensés. Et ne nous soumettons pas à la tentation, mais délivre-nous du mal. Parce que c'est à toi qui prenais la peine, la puissance et la gloire, pour les siècles des siècles. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. We being many are one body, for we all share in the one bread. The gifts of God for the people of God.
Thank you.
ruler of the universe, all creation yearns for its fulfillment in your Son. May we who have shared in the holy things grow into maturity in him. This we ask in the name of the same Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And standing together, glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to God in the church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever. Amen. God, Creator, with the Holy Spirit, call us from our own idleness to also go to work God's vineyard in this community. May we draw near to the Lord to live our life in a manner worthy of the gospel and to indeed be the bread from heaven. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among us and remain with us always. Amen. And now let us sing our closing hymn, number 526, God is our fortress and our rock.
Thanks be to God.